So this time I want to talk about a concept called the trigger. We talked a little bit about this in, I believe it was a goblet squat video that I had filmed before. Just the notion of getting tight and sending some more energy up with you out of the bottom position. We're going to cover it more in depth here in the press. But before we talk about the trigger, we need to talk about one of our action principles, that of hyper-irradiation. So hyper-irradiation is one of the keys to the strong performance of any exercise. It's creating more tension than you need for a given effort. There are a few different ways to do this, but it basically comes down to getting tight. So I can use the grip on both my kettlebell hand and my non-kettlebell hand to create tension that's going to help stabilize the shoulder joints and pack those shoulders before I press. I can also engage the muscles of my feet by sort of gripping the floor, and I can engage the muscles of my thighs by lifting my kneecaps. So gripping the floor, lifting the kneecaps, and crushing the grip on both the pressing and non-pressing side. Now I've got basically everything that I can behind the effort of this one kettlebell press. These are my foundation for the press. The tension I have in my legs, coupled with the power breath in, those are the things that are going to keep my press a press and not an exercise in futility. What we talk about is shooting a cannon from a canoe. So I want to shoot my cannon from a hilltop fortification that's not going to move, not from a canoe that's just going to get pushed backwards by the cannonball being fired. If I don't have the tension here, I'm going to have to do a lot more work with my arm muscles to create that press. Whereas if I have the tension here in my legs, here in my abs from that big breath in, I'm going to be able to convey a lot more force into that kettlebell and actually use a lot less effort in my upper extremities, although I'm still going to create maximum tension there. So we've got the principle of hyper-irradiation, basically everything getting tight from the ground up and from the top down as well. The one place where I don't show my tension is in my face. So when I'm taking my big breath in and getting ready for a press, I'm still calm. I don't have my jaws clenched. I'm not furrowing my eyebrow. I'm not closing my eyes. I'm not getting lead guitarist face, you know, just going absolutely crazy up here. This is passive. The dog whisperer, Cesar, I can't remember his last name, when he's talking about asserting your alpha energy over a dog, he talks about calm authority. That's what your face needs to be when you're practicing your strength training movements. It's calm authority. It's, I've got this. You might even see a little bit of a smile or a little bit of a grimace there, especially if you know that you're gonna get this weight, if you're feeling like super confident, and it can really help actually with your press to have a little bit of a smile on your face as you're doing it. But calm authority is what we're after in the face. Everything else is getting tight. There's a drill called the volume drill that we use in Strong First. The idea is that you can choose how much tension you're going to create in anticipation of an effort. This actually goes back to some studies on sprinters where when they were putting in about an 80% effort, so a volume of 8 out of 10, they were faster than when they were putting in a 10 out of 10 effort, 100% effort. And what happened with that was that they were just more proficient, more graceful. Their muscles were more supple. They were able to relax when they needed to relax. And that idea of changing the volume in terms of changing how much tension you're creating in an effort can be really helpful, especially for a drill like the trigger drill that we're going to be doing here pretty soon. When I clean the bell and I get into my rack position and I'm getting tight, I'm using the principle of hyper irradiation to create that tension in my body, I don't want to go straight to 10. I want to start off at maybe a 6 or 7. So if that's a 10, then I want to, and this is like a 4, then I want to be somewhere in between there. And that's going to be about right for getting tight, just in the rack position in anticipation of the press. We take our breath in just before we press. And as we start to press, we're going to use what's called the trigger. So we're tight here, but we're not as tight as we could be. I'm going to take my big breath in. And then when I decide to go, I'm going to turn that 6 into an 8 or 9. Just momentarily to start that press. I can even use this on my loaded clean practice if I'm not pressing through a full range of motion yet. Get tight, but not all the way tight. Big breath in. And then relax. Get tight. Big breath in. And then relax. When we're doing repetitions of the press, we hit that trigger and press. And then on the way back down, I'm gonna take that back down to a 6 or 7. From the 8 or 9 that I used to get the bell up there. When I'm in the rack position, I'm not gonna let go completely. I'm gonna keep 4, 5, 6 out of 10 level of tension before I start the next repetition. In a long set of presses, and my idea of a long set of presses is like 5 to 6 repetitions, because each one takes so much effort because of the amount of tension that you're creating in there. You're not gonna be using a maximum weight if you're doing a set of 5 or 6 presses. So your first couple of reps, you might be able to hang out at like a 3 or 4 in the rack position and trigger up to a 6 or 7. By the time you get to the last reps in your set, I want you to have enough resources left that you can hang out in the rack position at about a 6 or 7 and trigger up to a 9 or 10. Because when you're getting near the end of the set, that's when you'll need those highest tension efforts. So that's the trigger. We talked about hyper irradiation. We talked about the volume drill. Same song, just turn it down a little bit. Like, don't go all the way to 10 right away. Save a little bit in the tank and then spike that volume when it's time for you to actually go on your press with the trigger. The big breath in might actually feel like it's making you more tense without you increasing your tension effort. That's one of the beautiful things about the power of breathing during strength training. Big breath in, everything gets locked into place. Everything gets more solid, more stable, without you actually having to do any more effort before you start the drill that you're doing. So that's the trigger. Next up, we're gonna talk about the active negative.